As we mentioned earlier in the show, last night was the Met Gala, and the theme of the evening was China through the looking glass.
Here to discuss who rocked and who bombed on the red carpet are celebrity stylist Phillip Bloch and cultural critic Emil Wilbekin.
Emil!
Cinco de Mayo!
Looks like some people were dressed for Cinco de Mayo last night.
Yes, they were.
So let's start with Miss Sarah Jessica Parker. Everyone's talking about her today. She had the ornate Philip Tracy headpiece and an H&M dress. Emil, what'd you think?
A for effort, but it's just like too much. This looks like literally like a costume. Mm. And the thing is, she did like a headdress that was similar to this, I think, last year.
Right, she loves her headdresses.
But the dress is not a great dress to me, and I'm used to seeing her in like Oscar de la Renta or something very, very luxe, rich. I just, it's too much.
It was H&M.
It was H&M.
It looks like a DIY from H&M. Yeah. Like, oh, let me put this like Asian-inspired ribbon on there. The headdress is fantastic if she just stopped there. She was just ahead.
Right. She could have worn a cat suit,
It's very over the top.
Yeah. So you like the headdress, kind
of? I like the headdress.
Okay, and you did not like the headdress.
I like the headdress, kind of.
Okay. It's over just the top, but it works.
My thing is, if it's going to be over the top, you've got to do it at the Met Gala. Like, this is the only place she could wear.
But then I want her in a kimono.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm with it. Do the whole outfit.
Not the DIY H&M. I just want to know how much she got paid to wear the H&M dress. Let's talk about
good
that.
Good point. Good
Thank
point.
You, because you and point. Janelle Monáe wore them too, so you know they were shelling out coins to wear those dresses.
Well, I'm not mad at her for that. Well, let's move on to Jennifer Lopez. Okay.
All right.
She wore a sheer Versace number, but was it a high or low in the fashion moment for her?
Phillip.
I'm going to give it to her because she followed the theme. It has the dragons. She's done this dress a million times. Nobody does it better than her, except last night. There were two others that came close, but I liked it. I liked it. It was not her best version of this, but she stayed in theme. The dragons were in the right places. Mm-hmm. That's what counts.
Okay.
And that face.
Yeah, she's gorgeous. 45-year-old woman. She looks fantastic. Emil, what'd you think?
I think
J-Lo and Versace. Did that work for you?
Yes, it works for everything that Phillip said. I mean, the dragons, it's red. And she does this all the time.
Yeah,
right.
I think her body looks amazing. She looks gorgeous. I don't know if I need all the cutouts and illusions that everyone was bringing.
It seemed like a theme of the night, though.
Right. Yeah, three makes the trend.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, and even Naomi was sort of cut out.
Yeah.
And
Joan Smalls
as well. Exactly.
What was behind that, gentlemen? Because everyone seemed naked last night.
Desperation and
well,
attention.
Well, I think that ever since Rihanna went nude to the CFDA Awards basically last year, I think, you know, people then think about that. And so then stylists think about that. And designers, you know, kind of embellish on that.
Well,
and
let's just go back to Halle Berry at the Oscars. Thank you very much.
Oh, you did do that.
Yeah, and that's where it started. And that was taking a risk then, and that's, you couldn't do all that nakedness then.
Right.
Yes.
We started small, and now it's just J-Lo has blown it out of the water, and Beyonce got all the attention, a year or two ago in this very similar dress, and now it's
which
just like,
Givenchy.
Well, maybe they're
attention.
Taking the theme a little too literal also. Yeah. I look through the looking glass, you know, looking through the dress.
That's what I saw. Yeah. I was like, literally like look through the looking glass.
All right, Jennifer Lawrence co-hosted the event. What'd you think of her Dior dress? She's obligated to wear Dior since they definitely pay her. She's one of their spokesmodels. Yeah. What'd you guys think?
I thought it was youthful. Mm-hmm. I thought it was beautiful. It's not my favorite dress that I've ever seen her wear, but it's very modern. I just saw the Dior and I documentary, so it gave me more appreciation for the work that Raf Simons is trying to do. Mm-hmm. I love that the midriff is showing.
Yeah.
It's a cool dress. It's just, to me, it didn't feel super Asian, and it didn't feel like the best Jennifer Lawrence moment I've ever seen on the red carpet.
At all.
So, is it too understated for you?
I love that she keeps her obligations.
Okay.
She's loyal.
That's all
I think she's very loyal.
Okay. All right, then, on that note,
Anne Hathaway.
She was dressed in a hooded gold dress by Ralph Lauren. Did this fit her well? Or did it wow? What did you think?
It wowed me. I think it's a beautiful dress. Yeah. I like the hood. I was telling Phillip right before we came out, I could see her in like an old Chinese movie, like as a spy.
Wong.
She's like a spy.
I love it. And I thought it was a Lola dress. The minute I saw it, I was like, Lola is going to wear that dress.
I would wear that dress in a heartbeat.
Exactly. Yeah. And again, for all the Anne Hathaway haters out there, which there have been many over the last couple of years, I think she's kind of got it back on track because it hasn't been so right necessarily.
All right, Madonna and Katy Perry. Now, they definitely ignored the theme.
Oh. Yes.
They both wore Moschino. Mm-hmm. I don't quite get the look. Explain, gentlemen. What? What?
Well, listen. It's for the graffiti exhibit, which might be another year.
I mean,
they're ahead of the trend.
Katy Perry had a bag in the shape of a spray paint can. Right. I don't get
it. They're wearing Jeremy Scott. Uh-huh. You know, he's very campy with his and very art influenced. I didn't love either dress for this occasion.
At all.
I think they're very, like, VMA, Grammy-type dresses. Mm. You know, and then the fact that it had Rebel Heart on the dress is a little too self-promotion for me. I don't know.
Is there anything too self-promotion for Madonna, though? Well.
No, but you know, exactly. But she's another one. Yeah. Last year, she had an amazing Asian-inspired outfit on.
Yeah, she was like almost a year ahead.
Yeah, exactly. It's like, get on calendar, lady.
She's got her calendars mixed up. But again, I think Jeremy is having such a moment now. The girls are loving it. And I think it's so interesting that people like Cher, Madonna are almost behind the pack now. Right. These are the women that inspired these girls to do what they're doing.
Right.
And you know, Cher was there looking all covered up, and she wore those dresses
in the 80s.
30, 40 years ago, exactly. And now she's all covered up. Madonna used to lead the trend, and now she's wearing this dress because Katy Perry and everybody else wears it, which is interesting. She's not ahead.
All right. Let's talk about some couples.
Yeah, Amal and George Clooney. Oh. Perfect couple.
Beautiful.
You know, they were in the house. Amal wore the popular color of the night, red.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
But social media kind of picked on her a little bit, saying she looked like a dancing emoji girl.
She looked amazing. That was John Galliano from Martin Margiela, Maison Martin Margiela.
They look exactly alike.
Yeah,
they do look exactly alike.
Cinco de Mayo!
Yeah, that's a little for the Spanish Arts Festival. But
it's a beautiful dress.
Gorgeous. I mean, the detail of what's going on in the dress. You have to see these dresses sometimes in person or close up, like our beautiful wall here really shows the detail.
Exactly.
And it's nice how you had the little pocket square to add, you know, accompany her dress.
Exactly.
And there's been a lot of talk that there was a cover going on with George and Amal for Vogue. And Adam Winter actually did the fittings of this, and Mario Testino photographed it. So there's something coming up with these pictures in Vogue. Wait
something
and see.
In the works.
Anna Winter doesn't just style everybody.
No, she doesn't. Okay, Kerry Washington.
Oh, my.
Now, is she an AKA? Because that's the only thing that can explain the pink dress and the green shoes. I'm sorry, Emil, I had to go there.
That's okay.
I don't.
My mother forgives you.
Understand. Look, shout out to my AKAs. I love you, ladies. But green shoes and a pink dress. Am I wrong? Was this a no?
I don't love this dress.
So regardless of the color,
you don't love the color's the least of the problem. The color and the shoes are the least of the problem.
Okay. Kerry is gorgeous.
Of course.
You know, and she can wear almost anything.
She can, but this.
But she keeps wearing these dresses that overpower
with
her.
With a lot of volume, and she clearly likes pink because she's worn pink before.
Loves
she wore pink Oscar de la Renta to the NAACP Awards with the green band around the bottom.
One of her best.
Right. So she likes that. She likes this very Princess Cinderella feeling moment. I don't know if it's super modern, and it definitely does not fit into the China theme for me.
But the interesting thing is, Kerry's tiny. She's a small girl, small boned. Sarah Jessica is a small girl. Sarah Jessica can carry off that stuff. Mm. Sarah Jessica wears it, and I believe it's the stylist. I believe the stylist doesn't make the bows smaller. I believe whoever's eye is getting the final look isn't making the bows a little smaller, the neckline a little lower, a little less volume. It's the styling to me. You've got to go in and get the proportions right. Design is what it is.
Right.
The back was stunning.
The back was gorgeous.
But this was
speaking
a Sarah
about
Jessica.
The back, we have to get to Beyonce.
Yes.
Okay.
She gown and I dream of Jeannie ponytails. Just pull up the top. Mm-hmm. But did this work for you all? What'd you think, Emil?
I think she looked gorgeous. I don't think it was appropriate for the Met Gala.
Mm. Why? Too much skin?
Too much skin. And this is like the biggest fashion event of the year.
And
she's not wearing a lot of fashion.
And she's the biggest star of the year of all time, really, of the world.
Yeah,
and she does not need to go there.
She's also a fashion plagiarist. I want you to take a look at where this look came from. We have a meme that shows Coming to America.
That's
good. Maybe it's one of her favorite movies.
That was good.
Yes.
Yeah.
A little homage to Coming to America.
Again, she's worn that kind of dress before, but she's Beyonce. It just seemed a little desperate for me. It was a little too naked, and Jay-Z wasn't letting her go alone.
Right.
You go with your wife.
I actually thought he elevated it because he being there with her, it kind of made it very more appropriate, but It's too much skin
for a
fashion event.
Really Vegas
quickly,
show.
Kim Kardashian, really quickly, what did you guys think?
Best look she's ever had. Really? I loved it on her. I thought it was the best she's ever looked. I loved it. I thought the boobs didn't look too big. Well, the butt is the butt, but it has the little Asian-inspired detail to it. I mean, the details are perfection on it. And for her, she's usually a mess and it doesn't fit right. Just saying.
It's definitely a step up from that floral concoction she wore last year on the red carpet. Okay, Lady Gaga.
Balenciaga.
It's over the top.
What do you think?
Top.
It's Lady Gaga.
I mean, it's Lady Gaga. It's over the top. I think the boots kind of threw me.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
But listen, she did the theme.
Yes, she did.
And she delivered.
Was it too literal?
It's a little anti-mame, but it's a little. It makes her look old, is what I would say. She doesn't look youthful. She looks like an older woman.
All right. And last but not least, Rihanna.
Love.
Yay!
Slade.
Yes. You know Sarah Jessica Parker went home and said, damn, I did not think of that.
Right.
And this is a Chinese designer, Guo Pei. Right. And I've heard about them for many years, and I've been trying to get their dress on somebody, but where can you wear that?
Right.
Here. Yes. So congratulations for getting the right dress at the right event.
Absolutely.
Being appropriate, a color
beautiful.
That just is beautiful. But where is the dress, is the question.
That's all cape.
Yeah.
Now, it's been compared to a pizza, an omelet, big bird skin.
Where's the dress is
Look
what
at
I
want to
know. There is no dress.
I've
seen that
one. That's Sarah Jessica Parker's cooking up.
Frying up
on the goblet. This made my day.
This is awesome.
This is hysterical.
I love
it. Where is the dress? Does she have anything on
She has something red underneath. I can't tell.
Because I couldn't see
it. No, I just saw a hint of red. But she slayed.
She slayed. The New York Post said she won the red carpet last night, gentlemen. Do you think she won the red carpet?
Shut it down.
She shut it down.
She won.
Turned it up and shut it down. Talked about this year and last year, so 2 years in a row for her.
Usually.
She's consistent.
The year she came in the tuxedo with a little bumped shoulder.
Yeah, exactly.
She brings it.
Okay, well, keep bringing it, Riri.
A lot of these girls, the Jessica Albas of the world that exist on dresses, they need to up their game.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of these girls that just exist on fashion really need to.
A lot of plain dresses.
A lot of plain dresses.
Yeah. Don't be scared.
Not a lot of China.
Not a lot of China.
And it's such an easy theme to go for with embroidery.
No one had a fan.
Rita Ora. We have to talk about Rita Ora really quick. Amazing. Tom Ford, red dress. Chung Sam, perfect for the event.
All right.
Thank you, gentlemen, so
much. Kris Kardashian, not perfect for the event.
We don't want to go there. Thank you guys again. We appreciate it. And now we want to know what you think of all these outfits. So tweet us about it at ArriseTV360, and we'll be right back. You guys always.